Katie Meyer, student athlete who took her own life. There's an update on her story today. So much sexual assault and other issues on college campuses that has been swept under the rug. In this case, we'll remind you, Katie Meyer, the star soccer captain, committed suicide after learning she might be disciplined for taking action against a football player who she believed had sexually assaulted a teammate who was underage as well. Here's what we know. Meyer's death came almost immediately after she received notice that she faced disciplinary action for an incident in which she spilled coffee on a football player who allegedly raped her teammate. According to an email Meyer received on the evening of her death, this potentially put her diploma on hold and also put her positions as a student and an athlete at the school in jeopardy. So she'd worked her whole life and here she was. In November 2021, according to the complaint, Meyer expressed despair to Stanford employees when she stated she'd been scared for months that my clumsiness will ruin my chances of leaving Stanford on a good note and was experiencing anxiety. She was during the disciplinary process. So the family is suing. And here's what else we know about that lawsuit. Meyer's family's legal team arguing that her death is a tragic reflection of broader issues with the school's egregious and reckless mishandling of its disciplinary process, they said in a statement to Sports Illustrated. The statement quoted an appraisal by a community committee at the school, which called the school's disciplinary process overly punitive and harmful to its students. The complaint in part reads, Stanford's after hours disciplinary charge and the reckless nature and manner of submission to Katie caused Katie to suffer an acute stress reaction that impulsively led to her suicide. Katie's suicide was completed without planning and solely in response to the shocking and deeply distressing information she received from Stanford while alone in her room without any support or resources. Through this litigation, the statement goes on, we will not only obtain justice for Katie, but also ensure necessary changes put into place to help protect Stanford students and provide safeguards when students are in need of support. In the university's history of sexual assault cases, Meyer's unfair treatment is just the most recent example. Janelle Miller, assaulted by former Stanford swimmer Brock Turner, has said the university failed to offer her sufficient resources and support following the assault. Around the same time that Turner was found guilty of sexual assault, the school faced a separate lawsuit for allowing a student known to have sexually assaulted four other students to graduate. Stanford's response to criticisms of how it handles campus sexual assaults has largely been to restrict alcohol and discourage students from walking on dark, unlit pathways on campus at night. School's punishment of Meyer, which her family says led to her death, shows how little has changed over the years. Stanford has denied responsibility for her death and had this to say. The Stanford community continues to grieve Katie's tragic death. We sympathize with her family for the unimaginable pain that Katie's passing has caused them. However, we strongly disagree with any assertion that the university is responsible. That from the Stanford University spokesperson. This almost makes me nauseous, Mayor. It almost makes me nauseous. Because here we have a university who doesn't really want to take any responsibility for their actions. They don't really want to change anything. Don't walk on dark, unlit paths. How about if you rape somebody, you're going to be held accountable, Mayor?
Yeah, I think to the irony of having your name be Stanford and you're not standing for victims is absolutely disgusting in this moment and every other one. When someone said earlier when you were reading, someone said that the school was over punitive to who? Not to these male athletes who continue to rape women. They're over punitive to someone who spilled coffee on a rapist or alleged rapist of an underage athlete. I think this is absolutely disgusting. And for the school to say that they have no responsibility in this, it's idea if you think about where people fall at in this country, how racism and oppression and misogyny works. You have these large institutions telling this person that you may not get your degree, you may be disciplined, and it may follow you for the rest of your life. You may not be considered an athlete because you spilled coffee on someone who raped your teammate. your underage teammate, but this person will graduate without any problems. This is absolutely disgusting, and it is so American. And it's that where we see athletes time after time, not just in college settings, but in the professional setting as well, get away with anything relating to the trauma or inserting sexual assault against women. And it's disgusting. It is absolutely disgusting.
Well, I couldn't say it any better than you. I want to seize upon a word you used, Mayor. You called it American. I concur. I agree with that. This is American. I don't know if it's just athletes. Sure, Brock Turner, star swimmer, and you have the football player. And sure, they're getting special treatment in general, all campuses, across, especially D1 schools, prestigious programs. But I think men in general on these college campuses, students, get preferential treatment, and the victim purportedly of these sexual assaults is always made an example of, if you will. What is it about the culture on these campuses?
Yeah, I think when we consider the history of American universities, this is a spaces that were created for slave owners' children that couldn't get into the Ivy League schools in Europe. So I mean, we're talking about 100 years or so removed, a few generations removed, where we was creating spaces for white privileged men, and college campuses seem to continue the space to be privileged for men. And at the detriment to women. And I think this is a disgusting space that we need to address. And if we could call in professional athletes for steroid use, definitely somebody, the Board of Regents of Stanford, should be in front of Congress talking about how this continue to happen on their campus.
Well, I was going to ask you that because people like us love to, and I think we should continue to pontificate and talk about this and put it out there. But what should happen? Because, you know, every time we do one of these stories, what I usually get is a reaction from one or two people out there who says, "Yeah, but guys are wrongly accused. You know that happens, and it's not fair." What should happen when a young woman brings a complaint or a witness brings a complaint and says, "This happened to me"?
Yeah, I think we absolutely should have a Justice Department that says people are innocent until proven guilty. But this is not a space where we should demean victims or people who report sexual assault. I think this situation will deter so many other women on Stanford, friends for standing up for their friends that have been sexually assaulted, or even people who have been sexually assaulted from reporting. So I think we should create a space where it's comfortable for victims to report what has happened to them. Yeah, we know some people may exaggerate what happened, but we also know there are so many women that never speak of the crimes against them. It's crime that I operate under the space that I believe maybe every woman I know has been sexually assaulted by some man. Country. And I think until we are in space where they are comfortable and safe to talk about that, we're not in a space to talk about those that may have exaggerated a story without going through the process.
Yeah, absolutely. Because I believe that Katie Meyer was made an example of. I believe she was made an example of. When you say, Mayor, that there's other people on this college campus who will get the message and won't be as forthcoming, she was made an example of. This was heavy-handed. Something about spilled coffee. I don't know if she threw it in his face or if she just, like it said, spilled the coffee. But it does seem to take away her whole future and any chance of perhaps graduating with honors, what have you. She was made an example of.
Indeed. And I think this, the tragic part about this, we hear this threat to her entire life, her college career, but no threat to his. And he's, yes. You know, I mean, this is, like I said, it's as American as apple pie. So we really need to figure out a way in this country to address sexual assault in a way that does not demean women.
Well, I'd love to see Congress act. I got another long list ahead of them, should they decide to do more. But I would love to see things exposed here. And I don't know who else was involved in pushing this decision. So we don't want to demean people. But you know what, anytime there's a powerful program, they seem to usually have powerful people like a college president, an administrator, an athletic director on speed dial. Probably got their cell phone, they call them at home, if you know what I mean. So I'd like to unpack more here, and I'm sure that's why the family has filed this lawsuit. I wish them the best. I can't imagine going through something like this, and we see another family having to deal with it in Stanford, another poor reaction.